Welcome to the Universe Effect. I'm JP, and today I will be exploring the topic of gravity. Gravity is defined as the force that attracts a body towards the center of the Earth or toward any other physical body having mass. But what does this mean? Well, mass is locked in a relationship with gravity, which means anything with mass has a gravitational force that spans long distances. You're made up of matter, so therefore you have your own gravitational field. But what about the Sun? That big hunk of mass that weighs 333,000 times the Earth and contains 99.86% of all the mass in the entire solar system, it must have more of an effect on us than Earth. But actually, since the Sun is about 92 million miles away from us, and since we are so much closer to the Earth than the Sun, the gravity of the Sun has minimal effect on us directly. The Sun's gravity affects the planets because of their relative size and distance from each other. But wait a minute, if the Sun has such a powerful gravitational force, why don't all the planets just fly towards it? Well, from our observations on Earth, gravity creates an attractive nature to mass, but there's a different story. Imagine a sheet of spandex stretched across a circular frame. The spandex will represent something we call space-time, the fabric of space and time, and in our case, the spandex of space and time. Moving on, when nothing is on the spandex sheet, it stands still. But when we add a mass to the sheet, the fabric curves. This is actually how gravity works in the universe. The only difference, however, is that our fabric is just one plane of spacetime. In the universe, there are spacetime planes surrounding the entire mass in at least four dimensions. We can also discover how orbits work. In the middle of our sheet, we place a fairly large weight. Then we ready a smaller object in the shape of a sphere. When the sphere is shot into the warp of the fabric, it revolves around the center in an elliptical orbit. The small mass is being attracted by the large mass, but has enough speed to direct itself away and miss the target altogether. Orbits decay at a smaller rate in the universe than on our sheet of spandex. We've been talking a lot about mass in this episode, but what is this mysterious thing? So far, all of the known matter in the universe is contained in the Standard Model of Fundamental Particles. We mainly interact with four of these particles on a daily basis. They are the up quark, down quark, electron, and photon. Our periodic elements are also composed of the up quark, down quark, and electron. And all of them have mass. But the mass is just energy. We can show this by using the famous equation created by Albert Einstein, E equals mc squared, or energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. And by rearranging this, we can find that mass equals energy divided by the speed of light squared. Let's talk about something else. You may have heard about the observation that the universe is expanding at an accelerated rate. If gravity truly is a long-range force, why doesn't all the matter in the universe just collapse onto itself? The answer is something we like to call dark energy. Let's go back to our spandex space-time representation. As you saw before, mass has the sheet warped downward, so the sphere would be attracted to it. Dark energy, on the other hand, is the opposite of gravity. It warps in the opposite direction, pushing matter away. We hypothesize that there is more dark energy in the universe than gravity. As of yet, we do not know what causes dark energy or gravity. So what does this mean for us? Well, due to the third law of thermodynamics, the entropy of a system approaches a constant value as the temperature approaches absolute zero. Basically, the matter and the energy of the universe will continually spread apart until everything is equidistant from each other and the universe is at a constant. This is called thermodynamic equilibrium. Enough about the death of the universe, let's talk about black holes. Black holes occur in many different scenarios. Most of them were created as an effect of the Big Bang. But another way is when a huge star dies and goes supernova, collapsing in on itself. The gravity of the star pulls in matter around it and creates a very dense center. All of the matter is condensed into one infinitesimally small point, which we call the singularity. The gravity is so great that even light cannot escape. Often, black holes are at the center of a galaxy, allowing the solar systems to orbit. There are some new theories on black holes, and you can check them out on this awesome video by Nova PBS. If you liked this video, check out our monthly podcast. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks!